Today, friends, I'm going to show you how to speed up an old computer using Puppy Linux. So let's get cracking. So first things first, if you search Google for Puppy Linux, you will find the Puppy Linux home. There are several advantages to Puppy Linux. My favorite is that it is fast, and it's free, and it's tiny. We're going to install it off a CD-ROM. So you do need to have a CD burner. If we scroll down here, you can find where they are. I'm having trouble with the download links on these pages, so we're going to go down to iBiblio. This is kind of fun because you can see all the versions of Puppy going all the way back to 2010. The version I want is FOSSA. I have used 9.5 a ton, but today we're going to try the F96 version. Right here is the ISO, and I'm going to simply download this and burn it to a CD. My latest PC does not have a burner, so I'm moving to an older one. I am going to scroll down, and we're going to find a tool called Image Burn. It is free, and it's simple to use. I'm going to choose to write an image file to disk, and then find the file. This search tool makes it super fast. There is the ISO. I can simply hit open. Of course, I've inserted the CD, and now I can click burn. That process took 2 minutes and 40 seconds, but I'm going to speed it up with video editing. And now we can zip over and rescue that PC. All right, so powering it on, I'm doing F12, F11. I want to get to the boot menu. It's F12 on this one. I'll insert that CD while it's opening. Notice I have not plugged this in a long time, so the CMOS is gone. I'm going to just press F1 to continue. And once again, I want that boot menu. There it is. And we want to boot from the CD-ROM. Press enter. It instantly finds the Linux on the CD. And then we want FossaPup 9.6 and just press enter. Now today, with this computer, this took 6 minutes. I'm going to speed it up so you don't have to watch that. Generally, it's quicker than that, but there may be something wrong with this DVD drive. It does end up working, though, so let me show you what comes up as we move on. And bingo, there's our opening screen. All right, so we can screen capture inside Puppy, but I am not gonna for today's lesson just because I'm showing you these steps before I really have it built. So I am gonna keep English USA. I am gonna switch my time zone, slide down into the Americas and the Detroit area. Bingo. Keyboard is gonna stay the same for this little monitor. That's a perfect setup. I do wanna get time from the internet, and this is one of my favorite things. Via the Ethernet cable in the back, it already has the internet set up, so I can simply just hit OK. It popped up a synchronized clock time. I'm going to say yes, and I'm going to sync it to the time server. I'm going to tell it to always do that, and I'm going to exit. First time using Puppy. We already did the location. I'm going to simply close this window because we're good to go. Real quickly, friends, today's video, these are all the tools available. I'm going to explore these more in a different video. Today's video is just going to show you how to install it to the hard drive. So the first thing I am going to do is I'm going to wipe out that hard drive. Once again, SDA, 150 gig, tell it OK. And this hard drive has two partitions. It has one for boot, and it has an ext4 for Puppy Linux. This is already set up. Normally you would have a Windows one, so I'm just going to show you how to wipe these out. I'm going to delete, I'm going to delete, I'm going to hit the check mark so that it does it, and I'm going to tell it yes. It is completed, so I'm going to hit close. Now I can right click and choose new. I want that first partition to be the FAT32. That's going to be where the boot is, and I want its size to only be 250 meg. And I'm going to simply hit add. I'm going to click on this one and make it new as well. It is going to be the ext4. I'm going to let it have all the remaining size, and I'm going to click add. Now I can simply hit the check mark and let it do its thing. Just like that, it's completed, and I'm going to hit close. I'm going to close this. We're going to right click. I'm going to go to setup. And now that my hard drive is ready, I'm going to use the Frugal Pup installer. Step one is to install Puppy. The source is going to be the CD-ROM, so I'm going to have it as this, and I'm going to tell it OK. It's asking a partition to contain Puppy. The FAT32 is going to be the boot, so it's going to be SDA2, and we tell it OK. A lot of times I create a folder, but I am just going to skip it this time and click OK. And now it's going to copy all that information to those directories. This is off the CD-ROM, so it will take a moment. Note if we are using a USB stick, this is quite a bit faster. Alright, so that's completed. So now we've got Puppy added. Alright, so let's set up that boot partition. Click right here. It's asking where the Puppy installs are. Well, that's on SDA2, and I can hit OK. I'm going to keep mine just in the root folder, so I'm going to hit OK. And now it wants to know the boot partition. Well, that'll be the FAT32 SDA1. I can tell it OK. I'm going to let it do both and tell it OK. And OK. That one goes that fast. So now we can hit OK. I do not have to create a boot CD. So now I'm going to eject that CD. We'll set it right down here just as a proof that it's out. Close that CD-ROM. Now I can close this, and let's leave by rebooting. It asks, do I want to save it? Well, I do want to save this version. I'm going to click continue. I don't want to put it on a CD. I'm going to put it on the hard drive. I'm going to do normal with no encryption. I'm going to save in a folder so I can just say OK. And I'm going to call it FOSS, and I'll put a 1 after it and tell it OK. That is exactly where I want to put it, so I can simply hit yes, save, let it reboot, and watch how fast Fossa Pup boots on this crazy old PC. Press F1 so that it can continue, and it goes from 0 to bootable in about 2 minutes and 12 seconds. And there you are, in about 3 minutes, we've got Fossa Pup 64 loaded and ready to rock. Friends, that is how you install Puppy Linux on an old PC using a CD-ROM. Of course, in the future, I'll have one showing how to do it with a USB stick as well. If you want to learn more about Puppy Linux, check the cards up above. I have a playlist showing all of the things that I have created so far. Friends, as I wrap up, I want to say thanks to all my supporters on Patreon. Absolutely love how that community is growing. Of course, you'll find a link to it in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching the video. Of course, I want to remind you that every time you click like, share that video, or add a comment, you're just helping the channel getting a little bit bigger. Of course, friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.